With the initial trailer and horse sergeant type gameplay out the way, we have the final piece of gameplay that Tailworlds have actually released for E3 2017, and this is the horse archer gameplay. Now this is some very interesting gameplay. Granted, there isn't quite as much that differentiates it from the last one, but I have found a few things in here that are very, very different. Before I start in this video, I just want to put something out there that I think is a genius comment from my last video. This was the video of the analysis of the trailer that I put up. This is a comment from Sir Applejuice, and he's saying that this guy in that we see in both of these gameplay trailers, actually not just the first one, but both of them, might not be the leader of this army. He might just be a high-ranking officer in it, and that would explain why there's pop-up of advice coming from people. Maybe this is the lord or general or the king of the army, and you're just a high-ranking officer commanding a certain troop. This would make a lot of sense, and this would be something that we haven't seen in any Mount & Blade trailer before. We do know this is possible, as it has been mentioned on earlier on in the GameStar article, and I really want to know some confirmation on this. This looks absolutely awesome. What do you guys think about that theory? Make sure you leave your comments down below. Another one I got was from a game developer, Reflax, who is working on the Hold Fast Nations at War game, which I got the chance to play the other day. But he noticed something in the gameplay trailer that I don't think anyone ever would have noticed unless you were a game developer, and this is called a Grounder Dev Tool. If you look at the player while he's standing on a slope, the Grounder Dev Tool basically makes it look more realistic. So as he's standing on a slope, his feet change position regarding on how deep the slope is or how steep it is. And it's just a really cool little tiny little thing that I think just shows how much effort Tailwords have been putting into this game to get this as cool and realistic as possible. I love the attention to detail here. But let's get into the main bulk of the video. At the start of the video, we see a lot of things from the formation side of it. The cavalry formation, which we didn't really see too much in the last video. We can see the horse archers are nice and spread out. Now this will help against other skirmish units or other projectiles coming back from the enemy, but it will make them more vulnerable to infantry, of course. But horse archers aren't really meant to be going into melee in the bulk of their fighting. I also noticed the colour palette of the game. It is amazingly bright and vibrant. Not only at the beginning we can see the different colours on everything, the blues and the oranges, but of course later on the enemies that they're fighting, the bright yellow looks absolutely amazing. I love a game with a bright colour palette, because in this time and era, not everything was dark. Yes, a lot of films and TV shows do portray it as a very dark and dingy time, but there was a lot of bright colours on weapons and armour and flags and all that good stuff, and I really love how Bannerlord have tried to portray that and not gone with the typical dark and dingy style. I love the bright and vibrant colours. We see small details like the horses kicking up the dust when they're running around in the sand. Of course, I think this will probably be different depending on the setting. For example, if you're in the snow, maybe they're going to be kicking up snow. And of course, in the grassy flatlands, maybe nothing at all or a bit of dust. But the sand, a lot of sand is being kicked up, and it depends on how fast your horse goes, depending on the speed it's going, will determine how much dust and sand is actually kicked up, which is another one of those small dynamic changes in the world that the Tailwords team have put into Bannerlord. Not only do you get tips throughout the battle from your, either if our speculations are right, your king or your upper lord, but you also get them before the battle. We can see that there's a tip from a lord saying that you need to rush attack them and overwhelm the enemy. Now my theory is that this will change depending on how your advantage is going into the battle. As an example, if you have more troops, if you are outnumbering the enemy in the battle, then you're more likely to get the tip saying just charge, zerg rush them, overwhelm them with your numbers. That is probably more likely the tip that's going to come up if you have the overwhelming numbers in this situation. Maybe if you have less, the tip's going to be like find a good position like on top of a hill and things like that. That'll be a really cool thing. That's obviously just speculation at why and how it changes the tip that you get at the start of the battle. But I think that's a really nice thing that Tailwords have added in. I did mention it in the last video, we see how big the map is, but as he goes over the hill of the desert dunes, you can see the sheer scale of this desert. How much of it can we ride in though? That is an important question that I really want to find out soon. I want some confirmation on the battle sizes, because of course it's been a lot of guessing and just predicting at the moment, but maybe, just maybe, we'll see something in the very near future with confirmation. Arrows look amazing. You see the mass volleys coming over. It reminds me a lot of 300, where they're fighting in the shade from the Persian attack. The sheer amount of horse archers firing their bows and arrows onto the enemy blots out the sun, and it looks pretty good, if I might say so myself. You can really see the different units, of course, going and attacking different points. This player is commanding the horse archers. The horse archers here are going around the enemy, kind of harassing them from the back, but over the battlefield you can see different battles going on in different places. This doesn't only show the units fighting together in formation, but the AI choosing to do separate things, and this AI is deemed to be very much improved and clever in its own wit. We also get a better example of the flowing combat. It seems to be a lot more smooth than Warband. We do have great combat in Warband, but it is a little bit on the clunky side every now and then. But this seems to be a lot more flowing, seems to be getting a lot more hits in there. So going from one man to another, getting all the hits in, flowing, getting them, keeping the momentum up with your sword, and it looks really amazing. And I still just can't get over the sheer amount of weapons and bodies on the floor. How this engine is rendering it all in is amazing to me, and I'm sure any game developers will appreciate this as well. We do see a little bit of the good old Warband melee coming back. He has a little bit of a 1v1 duel with a guy here in the gameplay video, and that is very satisfyingly nostalgic melee there, and I can't wait to use it myself, because of course it has changed a little bit, flows a tiny bit better. I think they're going to make this extremely satisfying combat, and kind of put myself out on the line, but I think this combat is going to be better melee combat than we've seen in any game to date. A very small thing that I just noticed very quickly is when you're selecting where your troops go, you have a big flag that you can select what orders you give them. It does bring up tiny little green flags. Now, there are many things these little green flags could be, but my speculation is if you have your troops, let's say you select your horse archers and you do an order, the little green flags are the amount of horse archers you have left. So it shows where they're going to stand, where they're going to be. A bit like if you hold spacebar in the Total War games, it shows the exact position that these guys are going to be standing and things like that. And it shows how many guys you've got left in your squad. That's pretty much everything we've got from this gameplay trailer. Is there anything you can spot? Make sure you leave it down in the comments. But the next video is going to be amazing. We're going to have some really good information that I'm bringing out. It's not in terms of gameplay, but there's some good information and some new screenshots that I have found that I'm going to be bringing out to you. So make sure you stay tuned for that, and that will come out in the next hour or so. But until then, guys, I will see you in the next one.